Oftentimes when people see pine cones, they're just fallen down in their yard and they think of them as crafts or something you kick around as kids. But in reality, they're responsible for producing hundreds of thousands of acres of forest all across the country. Hi, I'm Serena Oberry. I'm a tree improvement forester with Rayonier, and today we are at the Glenville Research Office. Back in September, we picked pine cones at our Hoopy seed orchard, and we're gonna discuss how we process those pine cones to extract seed. To get these pine cones, 18 months ago, we placed bags over the female pine cones before they were receptive to pollen. We closely monitored them, and once they were at a stage 5, which is when the pine cones receive pollen, we manually pollinated them with the specific male pollen that we had previously chosen. When we breed our pine cones, the small flower that is the female reproductive organ, that turns into the pine cone, and pollen catkins that cover your car every year in yellow pollen, those are the male reproductive organs, and together they make the seed. Oftentimes when we're picking pine cones, we have to use lifts that are often 60, 80 foot tall because pollen is usually on the bottom and the flowers are on the top of the tree, so the wind is less likely to blow pollen directly up and have a tree pollinate itself. These are the pine cones that we will be picking, and these were bred in 2019. Loblolly cones are real close. They don't sit on a petal, so you have to clip them off. So you just stick your clippers behind, clip them down, and off comes the pine cone. When picking pine cones, you want to pick them when their specific gravity is 0.87. The reason we do this is because the pine cones are not yet open. However, they have lasted on the tree long enough that the muscle mechanism that opens the scales of the pine cone are now developed enough that when the pine cones are dried, they will open. We use oil to test our cones for ripeness. If they're above a certain specific gravity, then we know that the cones are ready to pick. So we just take the cone, we drop it in the oil. This is what we consider a high floating cone. So as you can see, the cone has turned completely horizontal, but about 50% of the cone is actually floating on top of the oil. So this cone is ready to pick. We put 18 bushels of cones into a crate. Those crates are then loaded onto an 18-wheeler and transported to an extractory where they'll be tumbled and the seeds will be extracted. Cones are usually post-ripened for about 6 weeks, and then they are put into a room with a dryer for about 48 hours. And when the cones begin to open up, that's how you know that they're ready. Today, we are at the Glenville Research Office to see two processes. One shows how we process our operational cones, and one shows how we process our research cones. The majority of our operational cones are sent to a large seed extractory that has the equipment to process lots of bushels of cones at a time. What we do here for operational pine cones is we process a small sample of our cones to ensure that we're adequately pollinating and keeping up with the best techniques. Operational cones are placed into a tumbler. It's basically a large basket connected to a motor and a pulley. The motor and the pulley turns the basket, so the cones just shake around and shake all the seed out. Our research seeds are really, really important because one seed can make a big difference in determining if a parent is good or not. Therefore, when we process our research cones, we actually disintegrate the entire cone so we get every single seed out of each cone. How we de-wing the seeds, we put them through a seed blower to clean them, and then we float test them for viability. We de-wing the seeds because when they go through the planter at the nursery, the sower cannot adequately sow the seeds with the wing on the seed. Basically, you pour the seeds into water. If the seed sinks, then that means it's a good filled seed that will produce a seedling. However, if the seed floats, that means that this will not produce a seedling. For slash pine seed, we run the seeds across a specific gravity table, and with a certain specific gravity, we know that the seeds are good, and if they're below a specific gravity, then they're bad. After our seeds are operationally processed, they'll go to our nursery, where they will then be transplanted into the nursery, and those seeds will grow into small seedlings that will then be harvested and transplanted onto our land base. All of our research seed will be stored until we are ready to plant them in a genetic research test. The research seed is used to evaluate how good of a parent a tree is before we start to produce operational quantity seeds. Processing cones is really exciting because it's a whole year and a half worth of labor that is starting to come to fruition, and it's just the next step in making sure that we have the best possible seedlings for our company. Our pine cones in no way have any artificial genetic modifications to them. They are just bred the same way Mother Nature would do it, except we expedite the process. Rayonier has a really great internal research program where we focus on the most advanced genetics because it contributes to the sustainability of our company and our industry and the environment.